These papers explain an experience done by in applying the technology of MOOCs into secondary education. So we're talking about boys and girls about 16 years old, and they are learning in this course. They are learning to develop mobile applications using App Inventor. Somebody knows about App Inventor? It's a software development platform that you don't need to code, because the code is built by like Lego building blocks, and then you get an app working on other devices. It's really cool, and kids love it. I have tried to use this technology with university students, computer science students, and they don't like it, because they need more powerful tools. They want Java, and they want Python, and they want bigger frameworks, and they don't know how to use this little tiny toys. But if you get these tools into the hands of children, they make great apps, really, really. So this is a course of the objective of the research is to see if introducing a larger social group of students, larger than the classroom itself, way larger, in this case we're talking about 300 students working together and serve in the same virtual environment, improves the learning process. This is the idea. So we just use web 2.0 technologies, forums and wikis. This is very simple. Contents that come from open educational resources, and some contents developed specially for this course. So, if we talk about MOOCs, I think that we have already a track about MOOCs, but in this case, there are two approaches to MOOCs. One is the connectivist approach of MOOCs developed by Stephen Downes in Canada, which is about centering the learning into the student and let the students interact, and the teacher is just somebody that's going around and making and being a catalyst for the learning to happen. Well, the ex-MOOCs is the usual the MOOCs that are getting the hype with Coursera, with edX, where teachers of the MIT, and in the space we have something called Mediata X, where our courses based on behaviorism, but improve with some social constructionist techniques, but it's about giving the students content. You have to fulfill these activities. Some activities can be peer reviewed, but it's about this content, blah, 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 blah. You follow the line, you finally get to the point where you get the completion of the course. In this case, what we are, the experiment is about doing, we have one classroom of 30 students, sorry, one classroom of 60 students used as a control group. They work in a classroom with Moodle, and they do the same activities. They get the same contents, they have forums, they have wikis. We have, and then we have 300 students from different schools all over Spain, Catalonia, Madrid, Valencia. We have 300 students from, I think that it's about 8. It's described in the paper, you can read it. We have all of these students all around Spain, 300 students, in the same classroom, sharing the same forum, and the same wiki, and the same contents. What we do is compare at the end of the course the how it went. So some information. So we have these 300 students. We have the control group. We have 12 tutors on each physical classroom, because it's a strange experience, because it's about a blended learning MOOC, because we have the MOOC, which is conducting offline, but we online, and we have offline in the real world. We have the students who have a teacher that helps them. 18% of the students in the control group, 82% of the students in the MOOC. It's a three-course week. We have, during all the course, the forum for reflection to talk about themselves, among themselves. We have videos, video content for students during the first 2 weeks. We have an active wiki and peer for peer reflection in the last week. What we found is that the MOOC students are 3.8 times more active reading and writing than the students in the smaller group. And what we also found is that the most socially active students were the ones getting more learning. And they were getting a huge boost in creativity and in control and usage of the tool. So, in this case, this research is telling us that not the idea of MOOC, because it's blended learning going on here, but it's having massive groups, to having one student talking not by with the 30 or 60 guys that he has around in his school, our school. Being in contact with 300 other students all over Spain is giving them more opportunities and even more motivation to engage socially and to learn more. So this is what we learned in this study. Now Daniel is working to get 1,000 students in one MOOC, and we're going to have more results about this. So that's it.